Good afternoon. My name is Brian Benkin. I'm an attorney at Walder Purchase Hundle and Carlick, and today I thought I'd take a minute and talk to you about whether you need a will in Texas. So first off, a lot of people have a misconception necessarily of what a will does. A lot of people think that a will is first and foremost and paramount, gives away all your stuff when you die. While that might be the case, it generally does a lot more than just giving your stuff away, and we draft a will in a fashion so that it effectuates your wishes, not just for your stuff, but your estate, which will encompass more than just your stuff for when you pass away. So this is your, by having a will drafted, this is your chance to reach beyond a certain date and have your wishes affected for your estate, for your property, for your friends and family. So first and foremost, we have I get a number of questions from people who come from out of state, who may have had a will drafted in, you know, Ohio, Oklahoma, California. They come to Texas, they now live here, and they have this will from another state, and they're curious if their will is still good in Texas. Texas actually has a statutory provision in this estate's code whereby it states that a will that is drafted in another state and executed in that state with that state's formalities will be recognized in the state of Texas regardless of whether those formalities matches Texas statutory requirements for a will in Texas. So on paper, yes, the will be good. However, should there be any question as to the validity of the will or if we need to effectuate the will, those requirements can now be questioned in a court. So what in effect will happen is that Texas attorneys will then be arguing another state's law on whether that will that was drafted and executed in that state was actually executed properly in that state. A Texas attorney is best equipped to argue and analyze documents under Texas law. If you're going to move here permanently to Texas, it is your best interest to have a Texas attorney review your will and probably draft a Texas will that is executed with the formalities required in Texas, so that if there's any question as to the validity of the will, or if there's any contest towards that will, a Texas attorney will be arguing Texas law. That is the strongest position you can be in to protect your estate. If you have an old will, we would recommend that you also get it at least looked at, if not updated or changed, because things can happen over the years. The typical example is that your family makeup will change. Maybe you were single when you had it drafted, or maybe you were married and have now become divorced. Maybe you have had kids. Maybe your kids have grown up, maybe they're adults now. Provisions in a will reflect a moment in time. When your situation changes, a will likewise should be changed to reflect that situation. So if you now have, let's say, as the presumption is, you get older, you get wiser, you become richer, you now should start looking into ways of protecting your estate, that a will can be drafted in ways that can help you manage that estate. So we can start looking into wills that actually open trusts up to protect your assets, or maybe dispensate them into charities, or maybe you can give them to other beneficiaries that maybe you can include new beneficiaries that you had not thought of before, or new people have come into your life that you wish to make beneficiaries. Those are perfect examples on why you would want to have a new will drafted, even if you have an old will. And more importantly, there's a very important person we name in our wills, which is called an executor, another person who we actually trust to take our will when we pass away and effectuate its terms. So they're the person who's actually going to manage what becomes of your estate when you pass away. So maybe the executor that you initially had named in an old will is no longer around. Maybe you don't. Maybe you had a falling out, or maybe you found someone that you would prefer, or maybe the person who you named executor is not really in a position in their life where they can be executor now. And so that's another reason why we might want to either draft a whole new will or amend the will. And finally, if you do not have a will at all, I would highly recommend that you would get a will drafted. Like I've said previously in this video, a will is merely our statement to the world and what we would want to effectuate of our estate when we pass away. So if you do not have a will, what effectively will happen is that there are statutory provisions that the state of Texas have written that will tell everyone else what is going to happen to your estate. When you pass away without a will, you die intestate. That means you have not told the world what your wishes are for your estate. So what happens to your stuff? The state will determine that for you. And the state is hardly the best entity to determine your specific circumstances and situations or your wishes. So we really recommend that if you don't have a will, let's not worry about the state having their say and let's let you have your say. So I put it to you to find out more information, ask us questions, visit our website, wphk-law.com, see what we can help you with, and maybe we can get you a will set up. Thank you very much.